Namaste and welcome to the program presented by YTV Source with me, your host Sarala Karki. On today's episode, we'll be talking about various issues regarding entrepreneurship with our guest. Since 1990, Nepal has recorded spectacular growth in the field of media, in both terms of quality and quantity. Television in Nepal groomed up with the introduction of satellite television, that is Channel Nepal. Late Jamir Shah was a Nepalese media entrepreneur and the chairman of Channel Nepal Private Limited. He was the pioneer of commercial cable television network in Nepal. After Mr. Jamir Shah, his son Mr. Jockey Shah has taken his responsibilities. Talking more about Mr. Jockey Shah, he studied in England and USA on business, media and technology. He has 5 years on-hand experience in handling the entire operation of Spacetime Network Private Limited, managing over 300 employees, upgrading management, workflow and technology for efficient execution in delivering quality service and increase in market share. Now, he has ventured into software developing and promotional sector. On today's episode, we have invited Mr. Jockey Shah as our guest to address various issues related on entrepreneurship. You are welcome to our show, sir.
Mr. Shah, could you please briefly tell us about your journey being an entrepreneur?
Well, it has been quite an interesting journey from the, let's say, I've been in the industry for almost now, 5 years now, almost. And I was studying basically in America before this, San Francisco. And I was studying regarding media, technology, and business at the same time. And for certain circumstances, then I had to come back to Nepal to basically look after my father's brainchild, basically, okay. Which was Spacetime Network and Channel Nepal. And it was kind of tough from the time like I landed on the airport, and maybe like in a week's time I was already in the office. And one of the most nerve-wracking thing was I was seen almost for the first time by all my staffs. So we have we almost have around 280 staffs to 300 staffs. So when I came in, everybody was like kind of staring at my face, and I mean, where this young guy, is he gonna even like be able to handle the situation? So I came in and sat down with all my staffs. Basically, I started off as a reception in my own office, okay. And to just to know the workflow basically, yeah. How everything works. And there were certain issues regarding the company and its management, since dad wasn't available. So I sat down with my staff's employees basically and talked to them regarding the entire history, because I believe like history has a lot to say about what the current status of the company is. And maybe if I knew the history well enough, I wouldn't be repeating the same mistakes, and take the positive perspective.
Let me begin with the question. Your father, late Jamir Shah, he was the pioneer in the field of commercial cable television network in Nepal, and he even started satellite television, that is Channel Nepal. So we can understand that it was all his aspirations and spirit which made it possible. So were you also interested in the field of media, or how have you managed to take all these responsibilities?
First of all, if we talk about Channel Nepal, what happened was when I came in, there were certain, my father had given it to certain management company to basically look after the management of Channel Nepal. So basically, when I came in, what I did was basically I just got in a few other management, better management companies called the Color Bar, and got them into the scene, gave them an opportunity basically to actually pursue what they wanted to do as well regarding visual media. So I leased it out to Color Bar Entertainment, and they've been looking after that since, till date actually. And in terms of, if you talk about Spacetime Network, this is the company which I chose basically to come in and learn the entire mechanism, how the entire company was actually being run. And currently, it took me like around two and a half years maybe to actually get the entire scenario of how the company was running, what's the market situation, how the entire industry is being mobilized. And after that, basically I just got to know a lot of people. That was my, I mean, what I feel from my perspective is before you start a business, I think you should start learning to know people, okay. Make a certain network of your own, especially if you're a new person in a business or any kind of field. It's better to know the people around, like who've been doing this for the last maybe 15, 20 years now. So I got to know these people, and from them I learned a lot of things, like how the business was going, in what direction was it going, what were the issues regarding the government issues regarding this industry, and why there were certain problems in this industry, and how could it be solved, basically. So what I did was I came, I kind of explored, then I identified, and basically right now I'm executing my plans.
Okay. So it is said that everybody loves to see the beautiful butterfly or the colorful butterfly.
Yes.
And very few people have the affection towards the hairy caterpillar.
Uh-huh.
But the thing is, if we compare being in the media field, being entrepreneur, mm-hmm. then every outsiders, they see only the wow factor.
Yes.
But there are many hairy things as well.
Definitely.
So what were the challenges or problems you have basically faced out, and what are the challenges that young people who are aspiring to come in this field will face?
The most challenging part was, like, I was the youngest in this industry, and somehow I've been staying abroad for like almost 5 to 6 years now. So like all of a sudden when I came out here, what I came to realize basically, like maybe after a year or so, that like if you're a young person in maybe like whatever industry you are in, like let's say agro, or for my instance, I was in the telecom industry, for cable industry. So when I was there, like it's very difficult for your voice to be heard, basically. And I mean, like we all of us being human beings, and let's say not all of them are entrepreneurs, but we are raised in a manner, and we are sent to school for a certain reason. That was basically for, actually, I feel we are sent to all these schools and colleges, I mean big schools and colleges, for making decision, making a right decision. You see, whether be it in the family, your business, or whatever perspective. But what I came to find out when I came out here in this industry was, it was very difficult to make decision which was being accepted, you know, by the older generation, basically, because they have certain manners of working, and there are certain mechanism which they have developed themselves. So, I mean, what I tend to do is I try to learn. Every day I try to learn, like even if I make mistakes by myself. What I do, even mistakes, I'm learning. I'm learning every
step.
So
what changes have you made?
So the changes
so far in your tenure.
So the changes basically which I made was, the company was up and running by itself. The only thing that was lacking was a proper management system. I would say there were certain mechanisms which was followed, which didn't have a pretty much systematic base of justifying certain logic in business. So what I basically did was I sat down with a couple of my friends, like I could give you names, like Siddharth Thapa, which I mean, he's the grandson of Surya Bahadur Thapa. And I sit down with him, and he kind of explained me certain things, I mean, got me connected to certain people who actually helped me out on establishing a good base. Yeah. That's what which was lacking. So these are the things, like how I basically pursued onto changing the management. Then the next thing comes, it's a technology business. So what you have to do is, the technology, if you can see it in the world, it's like rapidly upgrading, let's say every year or so. So what I tried to do was basically implement certain technologies which would actually deliver more efficient manner of workflow, and create a certain efficient and what do you call it?
That's really positive change.
Positive changes, basically. Yes.
Which increases definitely efficiency.
Yes, definitely.
So joining my past question,
right.
What opportunities do you see for the youngster who aspire to come in this field?
I would say not only in this field. What I find there are like a lot of other fields which could be explored in Nepal. Since like, I mean, Nepal is pretty much very strong in its natural resources. So I think agricultural, agro-based businesses are unexplored yet to a full extent, I think. And even the taxes are maybe, export-import taxes are pretty much exempted, I think, for agricultural businesses. And for equipments based on agricultural equipments, I think it's 5% or something like that. So it's, I think like the youth need to focus on more like utilizing the resources which we already have in our country. But at the same time, I mean, technology, everything is there. But we have to also look at the basic needs of the country at the moment. You know, like the country doesn't have lights for, let's say, I think, what, 14 hours already now. And, you know, there are certain issues which the country actually really needs to look at. And since now the government has also changed recently.
Many youth policies have also been introduced.
Yes,
so
definitely.
We can hope for the positive change from there as
well. Yes, I mean, like, if you talk about Mr. Gagan Thapa himself, he's a pretty much a young politician who's come up this time. And if you look at his background as well, he's like also pursued certain entrepreneurship regarding agro-businesses in his past experiences, I think so. So like these kind of political figures or let's say influential people could actually give a very positive impact to the youth of today, to actually pursuing their dreams at the same time giving back to the community they were raised in. Yeah. So I think this has brought about pretty much a good change in the scene of youth entrepreneurship, I think so.
Okay, so through a common perspective,
yes,
generally people think that if you are from a good family business background,
uh-huh,
then their generations follow for the businesses.
All right.
And if you are not from that, if your family generally, if they only hold the, if they are only the service holders,
yes,
then they seek for the jobs.
Jobs, yeah.
So how to break this point, or how entrepreneurial culture can be developed in case of Nepalese youths?
I think that what you said basically regarding like, let's say if a family runs a really good business, if he has their sons and generations coming, they'll be good in business. I think that's totally a wrong saying.
From common perspective, our youngsters generally do understand in this sense as
definitely,
well.
Definitely, yeah. Definitely, they do. But you have to understand, like, from my perspective, what I think is like the youth need to be exposed to new culture, to new advancement which is happening.
So it is possible to break this?
Yes, definitely it's possible. I'm for it actually.
Okay.
You know, because let's say there's a guy who's let's say on a job 10 to 5 and he has a kid tomorrow, doesn't necessarily mean he's going to join the same service jobs, you know. He could explore, he could be sent to maybe, let's say, Thailand, or he could even be sent to Kathmandu University out here. And he could learn certain things out of which he could definitely pursue his entrepreneurship. You know, I mean, entrepreneurship is not only about starting a business or, you know, like starting up something new or thing like that. I feel like entrepreneurship is also regarding like the action you take and the example you set. These are the things I think which identifies the entrepreneurship. So I think anybody could be an entrepreneur.
Yeah, it is believed that,
yes,
entrepreneurs, they transform the business into sustainable and profitable ventures.
Yes,
it is,
yes,
believed that.
Yes.
So in your opinion, how successful you are in this regard?
All right. For my thing, as I told you before, I've been in this industry for the last 5 years now. And I've been experiencing certain issues regarding policies and different other mechanism of basically logic, business perspectives of different industries over here. I feel, from my perspective, I'm going in the right direction right now, because since what I'm doing to my company right now in terms of the human resource and all, what I'm trying to do is I'm trying to bring a transition from an old management system to a completely new management system. And I'm trying to introduce technology in the same manner as well to the people. Now, if they don't know it, they better learn. So trainings are available for people. And what I needed, basically what I saw from my point of view, was people in my office basically in my company were exposed to these old-fashioned culture of management and business perspective. But what I've done is like I've upgraded the technology onto which their workflow would be more efficient, and basically we could give deliver basically a very strong and lucrative workflow for, I mean, win-win situation for the company and the benefit for the people as well.
So have you and your business associates made contribution for building entrepreneurship, or have you been able to create entrepreneurs, or what are your future initiatives?
Yes, recently I've ventured into the software developing market right now, and there were certain companies out here who were kind of struggling to get up, and I knew this, one of them are my cousin, one of the programmers, lead programmers. So what I basically did was, they were having problems regarding finance, at the same time setting up a management system and a workflow basically. So what I did to this company, which is called Selenium Solutions actually, private limited, what I did to this company basically, I was created some funds, made some funds available for them so that they could at least start off with their business. I didn't have to say much because the programmers are really top-notch and really, really bright young kids. So these guys just took it off from there. Basically, I just helped them monitor it, but at the same time set up a certain management system, I mean, in terms of accounting and all these kind of other internal management systems. So these guys just took it off from there, and the company is doing perfectly fine now.
Yeah, it's really great job. Great
job.
Thank you. So your business, basically, we can see that it has been focusing on information and communication technology, ICT.
Yes, yes.
So are you exploring new ventures as well, in new field,
yes,
in new areas?
Yes, yes. Marketing promotion has been pretty much I'm pretty intrigued by this field. So in the recent years, what I'm trying to do is, since Indian marketing and promotion has like excelled in the past few years, it was to such an extent that right now it's one of the most powerful marketing and promotion based country at the moment. So what I've done is like I've created a bridge regarding, I've partnered up with certain Indian based companies to actually tie up with the Nepalese company to establish a new electronic media and promotion schemes. And basically this company is actually doing really, really good, more than what I had expected, because the companies which we are dealing with, the foreign companies which we are dealing with, were pretty, their expertise and their manpower, who were pretty much skilled in this area, have given a lot of impact and taught a lot to the local people out here. I mean, the local employees who they're working with. So, I mean, in the future, if they remain or not the foreign party, at least the people from Nepal, the young generation who are tying up with them, have learned significantly a lot from them. So I think these kind of ventures will definitely help the local market learn more.
Okay, I've read somewhere that you are really interested in the field of music, and even Space Time Network, it has introduced STN, which is fully music
STN
channel.
Music. Yes, yes.
So how you find your channel or your interest has made connectivity to the young people?
It has actually done a really good job, because last time the management, they have come up with certain shows like Hell's Bell, which was actually promoting metal scene in Nepal. I myself actually, let's talk about it, almost like about 15 years ago, 15 to 16 years ago, yes, when I was the age of 16, 17 and 18, these
really
3 years of my
years.
Life. Yes, yes.
Yeah.
These were the years where basically I established a band called Nastik, which was a metal band in Nepal. We were the first ones to introduce something called, I think it was a hardcore metal, yeah. So yeah, the entire credit goes to my parents. Yeah. My father used to sing beautifully. My mother, great sitar player, she used to play in the Nepali radio as well. So I've been seeing my father sing from when I was really little, and my mother always playing the sitar at the same time. So I got pretty much influenced by them. because the sounds, I mean, I didn't know sitar, what sitar was when I was really small.
Okay.
So when my mother used to play the beautiful sounds, so I asked my mother, can I play that? She was like, why don't you try guitar? Then I didn't even know guitar existed. Then she actually introduced a small little guitar to me, and I used to study in Shuvatar at that time. So I learned my...
So any future plannings in this regard, regarding music?
Yeah, I mean, what right now is happening is, like, if you hear about certain companies, like, for example, Silence Entertainment, if you've heard of them, they're kind of creating a really positive vibe on the youngsters, young citizens of Nepal, giving them certain platform where they could actually come and prove their talents. Yeah. So I think other companies or other people should also encourage these acts, basically, to actually identify a talent and actually groom the talent and make it presentable, so that, I mean, the citizens of Nepal, all of them could enjoy their talent, all of it, all together. All right.
So we are at the end of the show.
Okay.
What would be the suggestion for the young people?
I would say never give up. Always pursue your dreams. When the opportunity comes, actually don't wait for any opportunity. If it comes, you should learn to grab it. That's all I got to say.
And if any young mind, they have got very creative ideas in terms of media and communication,
yes,
how they can approach you?
They could email me, actually. They could email me. You can find me on my Facebook. There are other methods. I mean, you could call in the office anytime and set up an appointment. That would be perfectly fine.
It was an honor having you in our show. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Thank you for watching our program. Hope you like this interactive session regarding the entrepreneurship and its issues. If you have any feedback, you can send us at info@ytvnepal.org. Keep watching YTV programs. Namaste.
गतिसँग होइन सुरक्षासँग प्रतिस्पर्धा गरौँ। बाटो काट्दा जेब्रा क्रसिङको प्रयोग गरौँ। गाडी चालकहरूले पैदल यात्रीलाई प्राथमिकता दिउँ। रातो बत्ती बलेको बेला बाटो काट्ने गरौँ। जथाभावी बाटो काटेर दुर्घटनाको समाचार नबनाऊ। आकाशे पुल प्रयोग गरी सभ्य नागरिकको परिचय दिउँ। दमकल एम्बुलेन्सलाई प्राथमिकता दिउँ। पैदल यात्रीले फुटपाथको प्रयोग गरौँ। ट्राफिक चिन्हको जानकारी हासिल गरौँ। गाडीमा झुन्डिएर यात्रा नगरौँ। अरूलाई बाधा पुग्ने गरी सवारी पार्क नगरौँ। मादक पदार्थ सेवन गरी सवारी नचलाउँ। सवारी चलाउँदा मोबाइलको प्रयोग नगरौँ। सवारी चलाउँदा अनिवार्य सिट बेल्टको प्रयोग गरौँ। साइरनवाला गाडीलाई प्राथमिकता दिउँ। ट्राफिक नियम पालना गरौँ।
अधिकार खोजौँ तर आफ्नो कर्तव्य पनि पालना गरौँ। युवा प्रेरित कार्यक्रम टेलिभिजन मार्फत प्रसारण गर्नु परेमा हामीलाई सम्पर्क गर्नुहोला। युटिभी सोज फोन नम्बर 478453535 बुद्धनगर काठमाडौँ।
स्टुडियो एडिटिङ टेलिभिजन कार्यक्रम निर्माण डकुमेन्ट्री प्रोफाइल वा विज्ञापन प्रसारण सामग्री निर्माण गर्नु परेमा हामीलाई सम्झनुहोस्। युथ ब्रोडकास्टिङ सर्भिस बुद्धनगर काठमाडौँ। मोबाइल नम्बर 9841134338 9510 82240 र 9510720057।